One day I was reading some
Did you practice cannibalism or anything while you were going?
Well, actually, we did. Happy
spring. How are you?
Somebody rap on a glass with a spoon. Well, we will not be having the press invading us this morning.
Yeah.
We can get right at it. Since we've all been moving in Central America, Congressman Bob McEwen says so well at the recent House Republican Conference, the efforts of the Hondurans, along with the U.S. Army's emergency deployment readiness exercise, forced the Sandinistas to pull out of Honduras short of their military objectives. Kind of a dignified way to put it. But meanwhile, the Nicaraguan resistance and the Sandinista regime signed a truce agreement last week in which the Sandinistas promised, again, to democratize. The resistance is critically short of food and other items. I'm going to ask Frank Carlucci to tell you briefly about the U.S. exercise in Honduras, and then Colin Powell will give you an update on the resistance.
Thank you, Mr. President. Yesterday, we started to move our troops out of Honduras in seven C-141s, 751 soldiers from the 82nd Airborne returned, actually bailed out back at their home base. The remaining troops will return to Pope and Travis by 0500 on 31 statistics on the exercise. The total time from the presidential decision to deploy to Honduras to the point where the first troops arrive is 14 and a half hours. From the first soldier on the ground to the last on the
ground. God bless you from all your friends in California.
Thank you.
Rabbi Rachik.
I'm a fellow in Minnesota.
I'm
from Wisconsin.
Nice to see you.
It's my older brother.
Well, nice to see you.
No, wait, man, I'm also sorry. Picture. Now, Marianne, you can spot this also. Yes. I think we better do it over here on the side.
And then maybe I can have this gentleman step in, right in there. That would be fine.
I'm going to move this.
Okay. Maybe we can all come up this way. That's great.
Even closer?
Even closer.
Things probably have to go this way a little bit.
Yeah. If they want to come right behind the president, that would be... Yeah, that's better.
President, you'll have to come around behind him now to sign it since we're squeezing in so close. All right, we'll bring the still photographers in.
Well, the ethical teachings of the Lubavitcher Rebbe have as much relevance today as they ever have. The values upon which the movement is based, wisdom, reverence, are not just desirable, they're necessary for the very survival of civilization. And now we shall proclaim this day, Education Day. And please give my warmest regards to the Rebbe on this, his 86th birthday.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
The Rebbe sends his regards to you, Mr. President, and he expresses his wishes, as he always did, that he should be able to carry out the extraordinary role that the Almighty has assigned to you, as you have until now, with health and happiness, together with the First Lady, for many years to come. In whatever position you'll be filling, we all look forward to you to continue the great work, historical work that you have started on behalf of education, specifically by returning the traditional values which have been the bedrock of civilization ever since beginning. And these are the seven Noahide laws contained and given by Moses, as it is reflected here in this scroll. We thank you very much on behalf of all our colleagues, of the entire Jewish people, especially with the approach of the Passover holiday throughout the world.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
God bless you, Mr. President. Have a safe trip back home.
Well, thank you all. I'm looking forward to that.
Thank you. God bless you, and you should just continue to succeed in everything.
Celebrating your 86th birthday and 96th.
Thank you. And that's good.
God bless you. God bless you.
Jason Roberts, and that very foolish man, foolish. Oh, how are you, Mr. Dominic?
Just fine.
All right.
Hello, how are you?
Senator, you are right over here. Senator, you're right here.
See how this works? I'm getting the feet of the mask. You know, Senator, you doing all right?
Yeah. Senator Garn, you're right here.
That's great.
A gap has grown between us and the Soviet Union.